is up, guys? I'm Producer GB, and we are back with some more Naruto Online. And today, we're going to be doing a team showcase today. I know you guys see, you know, a face cam. I'm going to try to do more videos with face cam. Not everything's going to have face cam, but most stuff, I'm going to try to have face cam in it. But some of the Let's Plays that's going on that don't have face cam right now, those will continue not to have Let's Plays until I start a new Let's Play. But Naruto Online, I'm going to try to do more face cam stuff with live commentary stuff. But since we're doing a team showcase today, it's all about the team. So let's get into the arena and show off the team that I'm going to be using. Now, this is the team I'm going to be using. I want to try to use Great Ninja War Ino because she was available last month. And I'm going to do a review of Great Ninja War Ino. So I wanted to do a team first and show off the team that I've been using with her. It's an okay team. It's not no team that's going to be like some Raikage team or some Shisui team. So don't expect this team to just go ham on those type of teams. It's one of those average teams that's in the middle of the, you know, average team slots that can fight other average teams. So let's start with Win Main first and her talents before we start anything else. I'm using Giant Rasengan is to start off the combo with Giant Rasengan, and if I can keep clones up, I can do her cooldown goes down by one, is reduced by one if I have two clones up, so that can help constantly go over and over if they can't take out the clones. Also have shadow clones, so I can put up clones. They do taijutsu to the deck, they just low float, the team chases low float, so they actually help if nobody starts a combo in that round with a standard attack. Most likely the clones will start a standard attack. We also have shot down Rasengan, this repost to knock down. It could chase twice per round, and I think you also get this chase off. You get this chase off twice if you do your mystery. Then we have Wind Dance. It's to boost the characters in the same column or the same row as her. That's going this way and not this, like up and down. It's going more side to side, so it boosts people who's going side to side from her. Their ninjutsu and their resistance by 40%. Then we have multi shadow clones that starts off the battle with 3 shadow clones, so it can help, you know, try to get her Giant Rasengan, and it can protect some standard attacks. And then we're using the bull, so people who don't have like the gold summonings that have purple summonings can also use this team. Now the next character we are using in the team is Ginkaku. If I can move him up, I think this one's Ginkaku. Yeah, Ginkaku. We use a Ginkaku because he has immobile, because if he does his mystery, he immobile somebody, then she chases someone immobile. And so you can do that in the first round, immobile somebody, then get them chaos so they can attack their own teammate. Then he also does repulse to acupuncture, so acupuncture is always helped. More CC is chased as acupuncture. He can chase twice, is knocked down to low float. He adds 50% damage to Kage, so if you fight Kage, you get 50% more damage. Before each action, he can recover life. Life points based on his ninjutsu attribute, so he can basically heal every round like Roshi and stuff like that, and also recovers 20 chakra, so each chakra points. Then we have Kinkaku. Now Kinkaku, he's there for the chase, because the chase, all his chase is immobile, is just low float to knockdown, and it goes well with Kinkaku's knockdown to low float. So when you chase, you could also use Ino's chaos. Every time this guy suffers an attack, you can ignite somebody, so he's just like Roshi if somebody attacks him. He does like Tenten's fan, you know, damage thing. It doesn't do as much damage as Tenten, but it does an okay amount of damage. It even says right there, it does medium damage to opponents, entire team. And he gives shields to Ginkaku and Kinkaku, or basically Edo Tensei, but the only two Edo Tensei is just Ginkaku and Kinkaku. So they get an 80% shield based on the unit's resistance. So that's why he's there. He's mostly there for the chase, so he can get immobile. Then we have Ino. You actually can use any Ino for this team, but I'll probably recommend Swimsuit Ino, because this Ino works with secret technique ninjas, and there's no secret technique ninjas on this team. I just got her because she can chase immobile and she sleeps. If she has Shikamaru on her team, she would be able to chase, you know, or do two chaoses to two people with her mystery. But she just here to chase all the immobiles and stuff like that. Every time this unit triggers a chase, you give her 15 chakra. So this team can kind of keep chakra because he gives chakra and she gets chakra every time she chases. And that's basically what the team is. I'll show you the combo. You do a riposte from the wind main and go riposte to knockdown, knockdown to riposte, riposte to knockdown, knockdown to low float, if I can get to him, low float and acupunctures, and then low float to knockdown immobiles, and then knockdown to low float to knockdown, and then she chases the immobile target. So this team, you can have like two people immobile at the same time. So let's try to get to into a match and see how this works and see if you guys enjoy the team. All right, we have a team. Oh, he has Tendo. That's pretty cool. He's usually actually using Choja in the back. So we're not going to be faster to stop him, but we're going to hit Choja with the Chaos. There we go. Get Choja Chaos. Animal Path Pain doesn't start any combo chase, so we're gonna go after Tendo maybe next round. Or should I might go after his Water Main just to get her out so she stop healing. So I think I'm gonna go for that because Tendo needs 80 chakra and I don't see anybody that gives that much chakra right now. He will have it probably next round. Let's go after her and keep her Chaos for stop healing Choja. Because the more Choja get healed, the stronger he gets. Alright, let's stop Choja because Choja doesn't have a prompt. So he's going to take forever for him to go off so we can Chaos him. That's why Choja is kind of a little bit bad. We still have two clones when we did our mystery, so we got it. It's right back to, you know, one cooldown. So next round we have it up again. We're gonna use it again on Wind Main to keep her Chaos and not healing. I mean, not Wind Main, Water Main. Boom, 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 boom. There we go. Keep her Chaos. And since we used our mystery, we got it right back. Let's use him to do more damage because that's basically what he's there for, just to do AoE damage to everybody and for his chase to immobile. Next round we'll be able to take out Water Main. Give us a heal. Oh yeah, Eno also has a heal. It's not a real good heal, but it's a heal, you know. Yeah, I'll take a small heal than any than no heal. Alright, let's see if we can damn it, I didn't click the Tendo on. I actually messed it up. Let's see if my computer goes for him. Since I accidentally clicked it without clicking a person. Or is he going to go for Choja? Yeah. The computer is dumb. Like, you can still go for the right person. It's not going to matter. Because he shouldn't, like, burst me or one-shot me or nothing. He's not boosted with all this, like, attack and stuff and ninjutsu. Still did a lot of damage, though. Look how powerful he is. Took out all my clones and did a good amount of, a chunk of damage to me. Alright, we're gonna go after Choja with our Rasengan. Because this should kill Tendo. He should be mobile, and then we're gonna use Kinkaku to do some more damage. Surprised this guy haven't left yet. He should leave. He can't do anything. Because I'm keeping him in a permanent chaos. Boom! Eno should kill him. Or maybe not, because her mystery doesn't do that much damage. And there we go. Victory. Victory. Let's claim these. Let's get another match in. And see if depends how long the other match is. I might do one more after that. Let's see how long this match takes. Alright, a real quick one. Who is it?
Who is it? It's a friend of mine. Who is it?
Let's stop Sasuke from putting up his barrier. Can't have that happening. There we go. Chaos him. Alright. Check the clones. That's what I want. Let's just don't take out more than two clones. I need two clones on the field so I can keep using my mystery over. We're gonna try to take out Sasuke so we don't have to worry about any kind of barrier coming up and stuff. Or either paralyze or fire damage if we could take him out. I don't have two freaking clones because the stupid lightning main with his attack the lowest health targets, so I'm not gonna get my mystery back, but it's cool. Let's see, mobile him. Boom, 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 boom. Can mess up his chase when he whatever he does. So his chase won't be that long. Okay, I got acupuncture. She should take that off, you know, with her heal. There we go. That's Chaos Lightning Main. Hopefully Lightning Main attack his own team with his standard attack. Okay, I'll take that. I don't have anything for the next round, though. I probably should have kept it to stop somebody. I only have Kinkaku's damage, so let's just use that. That's a good. That was a good chunk. I'll take it. He's gonna go after. Okay, he's going after Ino. Did a good amount of damage to my Ino. This team that I'm using, it's not about damage, because it doesn't do that much damage on this team. So it's all about chaos and people, keeping people stuck, so you can whittle them down until you win. Keep people from moving and doing their stuff on you. And if you know exactly who's going to go off next, you can keep stopping people and stuff like that. Or predict what move they're going to use next. Let's go after Sasuke still, because I want him out. I can't stop Hinata because she's in the first slot. She's going to go off no matter what. So let's chaos his lightning main again. There we go. Keep him from stop attacking at me. All right. Attack your Sage Naruto. Attack him. We're gonna try Chaos Lightning Main again. We can't chaos anybody else because she's in the back row, and everybody in the front row is faster than her because they're in the second and third slot. I think I have everybody on the team immobile. Like, he's acupuncture in the Sage Naruto. The other one was chaos. Okay, he's gonna do that. Let's use. Yeah, because I got stopped. Let's just use Gigaku's to do some damage. He's almost killing my Ino to stop getting chaos. Hopefully, we can kill some of his people before Ino's dead. We should win this. If he beats me, he had an awesome comeback. But he doesn't have a healer on his team, so he shouldn't come back. Oh, there goes Ino. You need to take out that lightning main because that standard attack is kind of annoying. Alright, we should win here. We should take out lightning main. I should have went for Sage Naruto to start a combo. That was probably stupid of me. We could have won right there. But it's okay. We should still win this. Once I immobile him, he's basically locked. He might die to just repulses. Oh no, there's no more repulse. Alright, we're about to immobile him next round. We should. Oh, never mind. He died to fire damage. Alright, let's do one more. We can do one more match. See what we get. Hopefully someone new. Alright, a regular guy team is basically a kind of a blitz team. It's all about buffs. Let's stop his Sasuke. This might be a more difficult team because this team is definitely going to do a lot more damage. Let's chaos him. This team is all about buffs. This is actually a good free-to-play team right here. If you can get Iruka for beginners. Beginner free-to-play team, I mean. It's pretty good. Who should I go for? Should I keep going for Sasuke again, or should I go for Guy? I have a feeling Lightning Main and Guy is the one that's going to do all the damage, though. Dang, I should have went for Lightning Lane there. That guy was going to go off, and I was hoping I was faster, but he actually used Lightning Mane, so I'm going to be paralyzed. He might go for either Wind Mane or, you know, oh no, he went for Kinkaku. Well, let's immobile. It's Lightning Mane. Attack your Sasuke. Attack that Sasuke. I really don't have anything for next round, so I'm gonna have to wait to see what he does, and then I use Kinkaku. Get these stupid clones out the way, so I could just hit them freely now. Yeah, I'm glad to do it. Now let's use it. Boom, 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 boom. Do all that damage. Nah, we can hit you. You got the clones blocking. We got clones, but you don't got clones. We got them clones blocking these standard attacks. Now you don't. About to take you out. He's taking. Ooh, look at that crit. He's dead. That crit from that freaking clone. Oh, he's not dead, but he's about to be. Let's go after Sasuke. So he can't put up his barrier to give him another boost. And let's immobile his guy. Oh, no, he quit. See, this is the team that I've been using with Ino. I will be doing a review on Ino soon, either this week or next week. But I will be doing a review on Ino for the next review. Before we go, let's try to get to 1,000 subscribers. That's our goal. If you guys enjoy, hit that like button. If you did not, hit that like button. Anyway, I stream on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Saturdays. I said Mondays, Wednesdays, and Saturdays. Like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the breeze.